Yes, Ben. Ben ran into the studio through headphones on.
You're not going to believe this.
What?
Remember when Eric entered to win $100,000 from the Daily News?
Yeah.
He won.
What?
And it's not a joke. We've just confirmed everything.
Wait. He was in that contest that went awry in the Daily News. Remember a while back, they had numbers, the number game, and they put out a misprint, and it was like thousands of people across the city had won $100,000.
Yeah.
They're very angry at it. And they said, all right, everybody that won that, send in your ticket. We'll put it in a hat and pick a winner. And one of you, instead of everybody winning, one of you will win $100,000. He won it.
He just won, and we confirmed it. We called back.
How did you confirm it?
I called the Daily News. I talked to the girl. Here he is.
You just won $100,000?
$100,000.
Holy shit.
They're coming down at 12 o'clock. They want to take photos of
How does
everybody.
It feel to win as much as Opie made just doing this show today?
Damn good.
we'll have more on this tomorrow. Bill Burr. The Rolling Stones. We all went to the Rolling Stones show last night at the Meadowlands. We got to get Ben in here and Martini Steve. There's a little problem. I guess we should get into it. Eric is very, very pissed off this morning. Extremely pissed off. So most of the gang today, very sluggish. Anthony went home and took it easy.
Yeah.
We all went down to the Meadowlands for the Rolling Stones show. And we had to be there at like 5 because we did like a VIP party for XM. They flew in salespeople from all over the country. Supposedly, they're all showing up here today.
Yeah, right.
I don't think that's happening.
These guys like to drink, man. Holy.
Steve!
Hi, fellas.
What's up, Steve?
How are you?
All I know is...
never gets old.
No. Will and the gang got hammered. But they promised they were going to bring a busload of some of these XM people from around the country over here today to check out the show, because they're all big fans of the show, yeah.
Will definitely make it. He's a trooper.
Yeah, he will.
And hopefully the attractive sales girl will come by, who's got some fans here already.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe Will could tell some of those stories that he was telling us last night. Mm. But
sounds like a good time was had by all.
Great time.
Well, maybe not all, but...
It was an unbelievable time. Alanis Morissette warmed up, but no one saw her perform. No one cared.
No one cares about the opening gig anymore?
Well, they have great acts on other parts of the tour. Metallica's opening, the White Stripes, Pearl Jam.
Why couldn't we get Metallica?
Wow, you
didn't get the Rolling Stones.
Metallica's doing their hometown gig in San Francisco.
You get Alanis Morissette?
And out of all the bands that have come out of Jersey and New York, you know, why couldn't they get one of the, like a Bon Jovi or somebody to step up and say, yeah, what the hell, we'll warm up for you guys.
And you got to respect that you're in your 60s and you're not scared to follow Metallica. That's pretty impressive.
They got nothing to worry. The Stones still play great. I mean,
let me tell you something. I love Metallica, but James Hetfield as a frontman compared to Mick Jagger, you can't even compare the two.
It's two different things.
Last time I saw Metallica.
Come on.
Oh, it was when we saw Metallica.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God, with Jim.
Hetfield, he just seemed like not attached to the audience. You know, he sounded great and all that, but when it came to talking to the crowd and all that, he just seemed kind of distant. Like
he's never been a work the crowd kind of guy. It's a stand there and
he's got an insert city name here monologue that he does.
Yeah, right.
You know,
so Alanis Morissette, I guess, went on. I don't know.
I didn't see her. No one did. I mean, there was like 10 people in the crowd.
No joke, man.
Well, wow.
They were just starting to file in when she started, and then this is the new thing at concerts. Then it's the hour break. An hour between Alanis Morissette and then when the Stones finally hit the stage.
Not like that in the old days.
Because you got to drink up, man.
Yeah.
Got to drink up. Got to get your beers in.
They pretty much just changed the equipment over, and then the act would come on, the headliner.
Remember, it used to be like a pit crew when we were growing up?
Yeah.
One band would get off, and the other band would just be pushing the drum sets right off the back of the stage.
That's it. The opening band would get japped. They'd have the headline band's equipment all set up, covered with sheets. And then the opening band would have a little spot front stage, and they'd get done, and then the headliner would come on.
Being dwarfed by the drum kit of the headlining.
Yeah, huge drum kit, and then there's this little freaking drum set.
Well, you can't cover up the Rolling Stones stage.
Oh, no. My
God. It was like 10 stories higher.
Did they have all the walkways and stuff
for
Mick? Yeah. That guy runs around like a maniac.
Well, that's what I was going to say. I last time I saw the Stones was 1989, and I'm thinking, come on, they must have lost something since 1989. the new CD's getting really good reviews and stuff. And went last night. I was blown away. Mick Jagger's what, 62?
62.
He's 62 years old, running around like he's in his 30s, no problem, the whole time. He's just ripped. He's cut. He knows he's cut, too, because a few songs he's pulling up his shirt like he's hot, but he's leaving it up so the girls could check out his ab work. And he's in his 60s.
God damn.
And there was like at least three generations in the audience, at least.
Yeah.
There were women walking around and you're like, wow, that's a grandma. There's no mistaking. That woman is a grandma.
Rolling Stones, swear. Love them.
All the way down to girls in their early 20s. You know, it was the whole gamut, man.
Did Jeff listen to people's awful stories around you?
I saw him in 1972. I blew the original rhythm guitars at the Fillmore. Back when I had teeth.
But completely blown away, man, completely. It was just a great show, an absolute great show. And I noticed that anyone else notice the planes were flying over all night long?
Yeah, planes were going right overhead.
Right through, you know, the top of the whatever, above obviously, but right split in the stadium. And you can you can almost feel what the pilot was saying to, you know, the people on board. You know, the Rolling Stones are, you know, playing right now if you want to
look
below.
To your left.
Yeah. Oh yeah, cuz these things were going right over the stadium, man. One after another. Every single one. Every minute, it was another plane flying right overhead.
Yeah, they did the same thing when the Who was playing over there years ago. Yeah, it's kind of annoying, though.
Right.
You want to listen to a song and...
Well, Mick Jagger's such a showman. I think he knew that was going on because he was kind of pointing up to the planes a few times, almost like, I know they're probably, you know, telling the people to look down at this point, so he's looking up.
It must suck. You got the middle seat on your way to, like, Seattle.
Yeah.
Like 6 hours. If you look down, there's 60,000 people having the time of their life.
Right. He's just leaning over to Keith, pointing at the plane and going, I could buy that.
Charlie Watts looked like he's not going to make it.
Yeah.
He's just tapping away on his drums.
Then he had the big casino.
He did, right?
He did. He beat it.
He beat the big casino, Tony.
He beat
the big casino. He had throat cancer. Yeah, he beat it.
Wow.
And Keith Richards still plays great.
Yeah.
You know,
how's he looking these days?
like an alien. He looks like an alien with a wig, basically. And Ron Wood just looks like a gay guy. He's wearing girl shirts and stuff.
Like an old queen?
I don't know what deal is. I have no clue. Do you know?
Yeah, he's married and has kids.
Yeah, he does. Holy crap, man. He was wearing, like, you know, girls, what's that one store, Express or Express?
Wasn't it him that his son was going out with the dog?
No, that was Bill Wyman.
That was Bill Wyman, okay.
Yeah, Ron.
I was wondering who it was. His son was going out with the mother of the daughter that Bill Wyman was fucking.
Yeah.
It's just some kind of sordid, horrific story. Yeah.
Well, Bill Wyman, I mean, he started dating that girl when she was like 12 or something, some ridiculous thing, and then he married her, and then they were divorced in like 2 years.
He decided he
trades him in at like 19.
Yeah, he decided he didn't need to do the Stones thing anymore.
It was great. It was a Kahlua girl with braces and pigtails.
But it wasn't like seeing, you know, Kiss at the end of their career, where it was like it was almost like kind of a goof to me to see Kiss. The Rolling Stones are still making it happen. And then the stage just kind of lifted up, and they moved the stage completely to the middle of Giant Stadium and did four songs out there.
That's something, the mechanics behind stage shows these days.
It was pretty cool. And it's slowly moving, the crowd is just losing their minds. But
a lot of money in that tour. Half of the parking lot is tractor trailers to haul this massive set around. It's amazing. You just don't get an idea. You get an idea of how massive this thing is just when you hit the parking lot and you see, you know, just the whole perimeter of the first layer of parking spaces is all semis.
Yeah.
Because the stage set is as high as Giant Stadium is and as wide as what is it, like the first?
It weighs 150 tons. It's the biggest stage ever constructed in rock and roll.
Steve is actually able to land in his seat. He bypassed the parking lot completely and landed his car right in his own seat. No parking problems for Steve.
There weren't.
But anyway, Eric is very pissed off.
Yeah, now Eric is pissed.
E-Rock.
Now, you would think, when I heard, because right when I walked in, I think it was Ben said, Eric is really pissed. So I go, okay, the 100 grand thing was a scam.
Right.
Turns out, no. The 100 grand thing is not a scam.
Turns out Eric had one of the best days of his life and one of the worst days of his life, all in the same day.
So I'm thinking,
start out great, ended really, really bad.
You win 100 grand. Well, all right, let's quickly cover that. Was it the Post? Or the Daily News?
The Daily News.
You better know. The Daily News had a contest in their paper a few months back. You might remember this because it made the national news. It's some kind of, what was the game called? Do you remember?
Scratch and Match.
Scratch and Match.
They're still doing it on the front
page.
Yeah,
there's a new one coming out on Sunday.
It says all new Scratch and Match.
So what you would do is scratch some numbers off. If they match the numbers, corresponding numbers, by some money values, like a lottery ticket, you win that amount. There was a misprint on these Scratch and Match tickets. So a shitload of people across New York that bought the paper scratched the number and realized, holy shit, I won $100,000.
And they were only supposed to have maybe four or five winners, right?
Total, yeah.
Total.
Out of the whole contest.
But instead there were hundreds because of the misprint.
Hundreds of winners because they misprinted one of the numbers. So their solution to this whole thing was, okay, write your name, address, all this crap, send it in. And we'll have a drawing.
Well, this
out
was
of
after
all the people.
This was after a lot of people lost their shit protesting.
Yeah.
They all wanted their money.
Well, we saw it on the news, and every story sounded like, "I had I had plans for that money already.
I already spent it.
I spent it. The Daily News. They can't take people's dreams and step all over." Like they were entitled, and it was. I'm sorry. I don't know why. It was all black people that were protesting. Reverend Al came out for them against the Daily News.
Celine Dion.
Celine.
Screaming.
Why buy these people? At least buy them a kayak.
Let them touch the paper.
Let them touch the money. They could break through the wall. Get the money from the Daily News. Awful woman. And they figured they would take all the people that thought they won.
Hundreds of people.
Put them in a drawing.
Right.
And pick the money out of the proverbial hat. And whoever won gets $100,000. How many total winners out of the pick out of the hat did they have?
Five.
Five total winners. Out of, I mean, I don't know how many people were in it. Do you? Do you know how many people entered? It was a lot of pissed off people that thought they won $100,000 entered. Five people are picked out of this hat that win $100,000. Do you know who one of those people were? Our own Hawk. Eric Nagel was the winner of $100,000.
He won $100,000 yesterday.
From the Daily News.
Late in the show, Ben busted into the studio.
Lily White, Eric Nagel. I want to know what the other four people are. I want to know if they're white, because I am going to say that it is racially motivated.
So he won $100,000.
Eric's saying, shut up till I get my check, asshole.
He gets it today.
He gets it today.
Do you? Is it a big, giant one?
No, they don't do that.
Where are they presenting it?
It's being certified. It's Wait. Coming to sent to my house.
Going to your
go
house?
For it.
Yeah.
Where do you live?
Brooklyn.
Yeah. Well, last night he lived at the station, I think. We'll get into that in a second.
Yeah, because now I thought when I heard that he was pissed off, I assumed that it was a scam and he didn't win the $100,000. And I thought he was pissed at that.
It turns out the Daily News came by, took a nice picture of Eric and probably the other winners, wherever they live or work.
Where did they take the picture?
Right here in the studio. In front of the
ONA sign, you motherfucker. You're great. Little promotion, too. That's good. And did they do a little quick interview with you about who you are and what you do?
No, there was no interview. They just had the names and they just needed photos. That was it. They're doing some big thing on Sunday's
paper. But isn't usually Eric who works at blah, blah, blah?
That will be mentioned, yeah.
That will be mentioned.
That will be mentioned, Eric, from the Opie and Anthony show.
Very good.
And I think the picture's going to be in Sunday's Daily News.
Sunday's Daily News. Everyone picks that one up.
We got to call David Hinckley. David Hinckley would write about this.
Yeah, he'd write about it.
One of our guys wins $100,000.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how his day started. And then he went to the Rolling Stones with us, and he was left behind. And he's really mad at everyone, but I can easily defend myself.
You got from the story I heard, you guys ditched him, is what I'm getting.
We didn't ditch you.
In one of the most obscure places in the tri-state area.
Yeah.
The Meadowlands.
The Meadow.
Here's the deal. I drove to the Stone Show.
You drove?
Yeah. It was
your own vehicle.
It was Lindsay and I, Ben, and Eric.
Mm-hmm.
And we did the XM thing, meet and greet, blah, blah, blah. Everyone's drinking, having a good time, eating New York d'oeuvres, blowing off Alanis Morissette. And it's time to go to our seats. And we have seats all over the place. First of all, I had no idea you weren't sitting in our section.
I had no idea either. When you guys were going in that area where you had those colored bracelets,
right.
They looked at my ticket and said, no, you're going this way. And you guys were already way down, so I couldn't even say anything to
well,
you.
Well, that's I'm going to start with that.
No, you knew. You knew because you told me before.
I said, I have a side seat. You guys have the floor.
Yeah.
Yes. And they said, but we're all going this way.
Oh,
they
look at all the bracelets
around.
We had to wear yesterday.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I actually had a fourth one, too. There was a fourth one that I had, because you had one for the party and one for the floor. The cops everywhere. The security
yeah.
was
well, Eric
insane.
Had, like, one.
Huh?
You just had, like, one bracelet?
Well, this is...
sit in the back, stupid, written on the side.
Wow.
No, I had a really good seat.
This just in from Yahoo Finance. They found out Eric won $100,000. Hellman stock up 2 points.
very good. I thought you were going to pick another product, but you did very, very good, Anthony. So we were leaving the party. Here's the first mistake you made, Eric. And we'll let you, try to defend yourself here. We all went in the elevator together.
Yeah.
Didn't we?
Yes.
What happened to you?
Is this when you got there?
No, after the party, we were way up in the box.
Luxury box.
Way above the stadium, partying and stuff.
Of course you were.
And then there was about 100 of us from XM. We all took the elevators, these massive elevators. I don't know. We had to take like 2 elevators. But Eric was in the elevator with all of us.
Mm-hmm.
We're going down to now find our seats on the floor. Little did we know he wasn't on the floor. I did not know that, okay? And we started walking from the elevator toward our seats. We stopped to wait for you for at least 5 to 10 minutes. At least.
When we got off the elevator and we left, as we're going around the side, that little old lady who was checking the tickets,
yeah.
She says, no, you can't go this way.
Oh, boy.
And I said, why? And he goes, because you don't have that little band,
one of these
red band thing.
Oh, the wristband guy.
And I go, are you kidding me? I said, I know we're not sitting together, but they told me we're all going into the same area. No, you can't go in there. You got to go all the way around the other way. And when I turn around...
Wait, we have audio of you talking to the woman.
Liar, whore, you know it.
Now, maybe she was pissed because you were yelling at her.
Shut your goddamn pie hole.
So you weren't on the floor?
No.
Okay. So that's what happened, Ben.
Yeah, they wouldn't let me follow you.
We waited for 10 or 15 minutes, like, where is he? So why wouldn't you call us at that time and say that, look, guys, I thought I was on the floor and I'm not on the floor? Because that's the biggest problem here, first of all.
All right, well, when we got the tickets and I looked at it, I'd said to Ben, oh, I didn't get the bracelet because I had the side stage. And everybody else, I checked with Steve and everybody else had floor seats. So pretty much everyone knew I wasn't sitting with you guys.
Uh-huh.
I had no idea, to be honest with you. So, but you didn't call anyone.
Because you already knew.
Uh-oh. You had a cell phone. You got cell phone. Everyone's in constant communication.
We got cell phones and Blackberries.
All right. Well, at that point, when I wasn't allowed to continue past that barrier where everybody else was gone and they were already down, I turned around and went the direction that they told me to.
See, at that point, I would have called Ben, Steve, myself, and say, hey, I thought I was with you guys. I'm not. I just want to let you know that. It's definite. I couldn't follow you guys.
Yeah, instead of being led off to slaughter.
Because that was the last time. Well, seriously, that was the last time I saw him. That was the last time I saw him. But we had this plan that we were going to leave early, right?
Yeah.
Because it's Giant Stadium. It's a nightmare to leave a concert or a football game, for that matter, and get back into the city.
Mm-hmm.
It's a nightmare.
Yeah.
And we have to do the radio show. I was thinking, stupid me, I don't want to be out till 1:30 in the morning because I'm stuck in, crazy traffic.
So you ditched him.
Well, no, I didn't ditch him
originally. Hold on. Here's the deal. He didn't call you. To tell you where he was and needing the ride. Did you bother calling him and saying, Eric, where are you?
Ben called a few times. Ben called twice as we were leaving the stadium.
I got one message from Ben, and all I heard was the Rolling Stones and what sounded something like Ben, because I couldn't hear his voice at all on there.
Who do you think it was? It had to be one of us.
Jumping Jack Flash. Where are you?
You couldn't hear his voice.
Well, we had two plans.
Calling.
We had two plans. The plan was to leave after Sympathy for the Devil or
Don't show the list because I'm going to ask him a couple of very tough questions here.
Immediately.
So that logically that makes sense. Leave the concert early. We got to beat the traffic out of there.
Of course.
So we're not stuck for an hour and a half.
I never
to get
stay
up
for
early.
The encore.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I said that we would start thinking about leaving around 10:30, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Did we also say that we would start leaving after Sympathy for the Devil? Because Ben kind of knew the set list.
I believe so, yeah.
All right, so far 2 for 2, okay? So where were you at 10:30 or after Sympathy for the Devil?
Between gate C and B in the parking lot. Because I didn't know exactly where you had parked, but it was right near where that gate where we came in. So I stood right there looking and waiting.
So you were definitely out of the stadium at 10:30.
I was definitely out there, yes.
Okay, so far so good.
That's one for the defense, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, Bill and Anthony, you could decide
we'll judge.
Who's wrong, okay?
I see Eric right now, though. Yeah. I see him in a different light. He's a fancy person who deserves a ride home.
Anthony, first of all, we did stay for Sympathy for the Devil.
Woo! Woo!
And then we stayed for Jumping Jack Flash, which was right after that. And then Ben, myself, and Lindsay started running during Brown Sugar to get the fuck out of there.
Uh-huh.
Running. Ben's freaking. I finally. Well,
what was the last song they did?
Well, we only missed two songs, it turned out. You Can't Always Get What You Want, which I would really want to see.
That's a pretty good one to see.
And it's only rock and roll, which is whatever to me.
Yeah.
But just a quick side story. I'm sitting in my seats. I'm going to my seats, and some security guard yells out, "Greg!"
Oh.
And I turn like, "How the fuck you know me?" He goes, "No, I know you're Opie, but I don't want to like draw attention to you. I'm a big fan, man."
Thank you.
He goes, "I would do anything for you guys." I'm like, "Really? Well, how about better seats?"
Ooh.
Because we were way back in the floor. And that was me joking. You know how we are. I'm like, "How about better seats? Ha, ha, ha."
Yeah.
You know, let me see what I could do. And I don't think anything of it. And I sit in my seats, right? About a half hour into the concert, he comes by with another big security guard, and he goes, "Come here." And everyone around us thought we were getting kicked out. Like, uh-oh, what did they do wrong? This guy got me up to the 40th row. I was right there. Like, my seats were amazing for the second half of the concert. But knowing that we all had to meet, after Sympathy for the Devil, I started making my way back to the, back of the floor to find Ben. That's the only person because at this point, I still haven't seen Eric. I assumed he was still in our section. I grab Ben. Ben sees me immediately. He's like, "Dudes, we got to get the fuck out of here." So that's when we started running during, I guess, Brown Sugar. As we're running out, I'm like, "What about Eric? Have you seen him?" Ben goes, "No. Haven't seen him since since the party." I'm like, "Give him a call at least, okay? See where he's at." He definitely called you.
I know he did it. I couldn't hear his message because all I heard was the
Stones. Why didn't you call us back?
He didn't pick up. You didn't pick up. I even text messaged him.
Wait a minute.
No, I got messages from you when
later
I woke
on
up this
too.
Morning. Stop. You did not call my phone.
I'll show you the phone. You
liar whore, and you know it.
My phone was on the whole time.
Uh-oh. What is he doing? What are you calling now?
I just like the visual of them running.
Just running away.
You have to, though. If you've ever been stuck in that traffic, you're 2 hours in.
Forever.
Giant Stadium is ruthless.
Giant Stadium is brutal. There's only a few roads out. And so we run into the parking lot. Now, when we arrived at Giant Stadium very early around...
So didn't that affect your decision?
What?
Knowing how bad the traffic was to leave one of the members of your platoon behind?
Right. Yeah.
Willem Dafoe.
But it wasn't
on
like
his fucking knees in the parking lot.
But it wasn't like it was Anthony.
The helicopter leaving.
It wasn't like it was Anthony or Jim Norton, though,
Oh!
Eric's on his knees, both hands outstretched.
Yeah. I don't have to kiss
how
his
concerned.
Ass.
How concerned?
I don't have to kiss his ass. I got my own money.
How long was the conversation?
Right. How long did the conversation
you
last?
You put it into drive. You guys seen Eric?
No, well,
he's with you.
I'm getting there, but there is another side thing. We get there at 5 o'clock. It's Giant Stadium. The parking lot is pretty empty. So instead of going, "Oh, we're at D3, we're like, "Oh, we know where we parked," and we just run into the stadium, okay? We kind of get a visual like, "Okay, that thing over there, oh, and that light pole, okay, fine." So Ben and I and Lindsay, we run out during Brown Sugar. Now we're like, "We got to get to the fucking car." Ben's like, "Dude, there's 10 minutes left. There's two songs left. I'm telling you, this place is going to clear out at any moment." Also, we run out to this completely filled parking lot. It looks completely different. We all start looking around, and I wasn't drinking last night, and I'm like, "Holy shit, where do we park?" Had no fucking clue.
Oh, no.
So, as I said, "Where do we park?" I had my direction I thought I was in. Ben's like, "It's over there." Lindsay's like, "It's over there." Everyone is pointing in a different direction. And now the panic is setting in because you know this thing is letting out at any second. There were 70,000 people there.
Mix on stage. "You want to hear one more? Got time for one more?"
And we're just like scratching our head, running around the parking lot. Where the fuck is the car? It was like a game.
"Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Good night." No! New Jersey rocks!
Right. And it even got to the point, and that's where I you're so wrong, Eric. The fireworks were going off, because I guess they do that during the last song or whatever, and we still didn't find the car. We had no dude, we were running in all directions.
One more time for Charlie Wolf.
No! So it's kind of dark out there. We're in three different sections. And I'm hitting my thing, like, praying that all of a sudden I'm just going to see, like, headlights.
Yeah,
like,
you need longer range on those things. Man, with the lights going.
So we kind of lucked out. All of a sudden, I beeped, and I was only a couple rows away, and I start screaming, "Over here!" And then they start running toward my voice. You were not at my car.
I know I wasn't at your car. I said I wasn't at your car.
So you didn't know where the car was?
Neither did you. I just knew where the gate was where we came in.
Why aren't you calling us at that point?
He was hoping to meet with people. And not just find the car yourself. You were going to meet them somewhere because you didn't know where the car was.
I went to the area that I knew it was in. I didn't know exactly where that area.
You didn't hear us screaming? We were losing our minds. We're like, you know, screaming.
Freaking out. And like an
we
idiot.
Were freaking out. And we covered so much area, it's not even funny.
Like, and we were all separate. We
I
were all
circled around.
On phones, finding each other.
Dude, I had a run after I was in the parking lot, easily a quarter mile circle. Easily, just ran like this all the way around and lucked out. So finally, something started to make, you know, sense to me.
And as you're running, at any point, do you have any concern for Eric?
We called them during Brown Sugar.
We did have concern,
scale
and then when
of
we
one
did,
to 10.
Well, wait a second. When we got in the car, the thing was, he's gonna be fine. There was an XM bus coming back to the city. There was plenty of room on the XM bus.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, there's another mode of transportation
for all the XM people. All they were going back to the Hudson Hotel.
Dude, there was 100 people from XM.
Hold on, Eric. Did you know about this bus?
Yes, I knew about.
Okay,
this bus.
Okay, Eric did know about the bus.
Did you come over in the bus?
No, I came with Opie.
In the cut. Wow.
Came with Opie.
You're a dick.
I'm just saying, you know?
I'm looking good so far. Come on.
Knew about the bus, but he did come with Opie. Yes. All right. That'll weigh in the decision.
So you were in the parking lot somewhere.
Yeah.
And you called Ben.
When I got his in the message I couldn't hear, I called him. I even texted him. I said, "When are you guys leaving? Where are you?"
Mm-hmm. But that's a temporary crap phone, yeah. And I had the BlackBerry number, which is a Washington number, which is the temporary number that I have. Well, the other phone gets fixed.
Uh-oh. So now
that I wasn't aware of.
Ben wasn't
glitch.
Prepared
right.
technologically
right.
for the phone call.
There's a technical glitch in
Opie
Ben's
wasn't
equipment.
Aware where they parked. I'm seeing a lot of negligence on the prosecution's part.
I'm seeing negligence also. Right. Did you, when you got into your car to finally leave, Opie?
Right.
Right before you shut the door,
right.
Did you stand up on the bottom of the door and look around
Fuck
a
no,
little
dude.
Bit?
The
no.
Fireworks were already going.
I see no
Opie,
concern.
How many concerts have you been to in
oh
your
my
life?
God, hundreds.
How many times have you been to the mall?
Hundreds?
A bunch of times. Now, isn't one of the things you learn as a youth,
yeah.
the first time you get lost,
yeah.
is to always remember where you parked?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So that was negligence on your part?
Yeah.
Negligence on his part. He didn't know where we parked. And there was the bus. That's why we went
right,
the way.
I was like,
yeah, the bus thing
drove?
Really is a
group.
Right. I see a group negligence, but you got to accept responsibility as the guy that drove is the leader. You are the one that leaves the car and goes, "Look, we're at Goofy 5. You know, we're at Mickey 8. You know, you got to let people know so there isn't any confusion.
And there's always other modes of transportation.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I guess technically...
There was
in
a
your
bus.
World, you can always leave somebody behind.
There's an XM right. bus. This is ways to get back.
A Learjet.
We yeah. found the car. You the fireworks were going off. And Ben goes, hurry. We backed out and peeled out.
Flew. I mean, Opie drove out really fast, and we were flying. But
you guys would make
was,
some great Army Rangers, man.
Never anyway. Leave anyone behind.
Ah, fuck them. The Iraqis will pick them
like
up.
I'm the first person to leave someone at a concert.
The POW flag is a silhouette of his head. Eric's head just looking.
So we pull, you know, we're gone. We're gone. My phone didn't ring all the way to the city.
Is there any conversations about Eric?
Yeah, on the ride home, was there a wow? Eric's
I said, don't worry, he'll get on the bus. Or I didn't know Steve had already left. Steve lives right by the metal. And you got the XM bus, you got the New Jersey Transit, and then there's always limo drivers. He won $100,000 yesterday.
Yeah, he won $100,000.
You can get a limo easily after a concert there.
Yeah. A little resentment by other friends.
I'm seeing that
the
also.
The money's won.
The guy wins $100,000 and they ditch him.
All right.
Well, I want to know
when
about
did you know
the bus.
We were gone?
11:15, and I'm standing by the exit gate where all the cars are going out, and I realized they're gone. I got to go try to find that bus.
11:15, you know what I was doing? I swear to you, at 11:15, I was already asleep.
We were back in Manhattan.
I was
him standing at the gate hoping to see Opie's car drive by and Opie in bed snoring.
No joke. Dude, no joke. I ran home. I didn't even brush my teeth, nothing. I was in a nice room filled with AC, all comfy.
Eric's still leaving pathetic messages. Yeah. Guys, I don't see you.
Where are you guys? Are you still getting out? Are you still getting out of the place? Caught in the traffic?
I'm on the northeast side.
Right. I was in La La Land. I was in deep sleep because it was a long day. I was tired. I'm not kidding. I was out cold by 11:15 because we made it to the city in 15 minutes.
Nothing. We were hops back so fast.
Yeah, that would explain
the. I'd have to say that the thought there's other modes of transportation is a euphemism for fuck 'em.
Right. That is so fuck 'em. Now I want to know about the bus. Now the bus was
all right. So now
the XM bus.
You didn't realize we left you until 11:15. That's crazy.
I
because you knew we wanted to get out of there by 10:30. We were even late leaving at that point.
Because you wouldn't think that friends of yours would think such a thing.
Right.
Fuck.
They couldn't possibly have left without me.
You must have panicked.
Let someone else promote your HBO show. I'm gone.
He's getting attacked. He's the guy who's left. You're blaming the victim.
Right.
What were you wearing, you fucking whore?
We can never be happy.
You
anyone.
Rode over together. You left the guy. You fucked him.
I think subconsciously we can never be happy for anyone on this show, and the fucking guy won $100,000 yesterday, so we had to like...
He wasn't wearing the right wristband. He was asking for it.
<That's right. laughs>
You must have been in full panic mode, Eric, because I've got 3 calls on my phones from you around 11:15, 11:16.
I have 4 calls from you when I woke up this morning, so I don't know. Maybe something was going on with my phone. Ben knows my phone did not ring.
No.
From Brown Sugar all the way home. I'm telling you. And then there's one text message. So I see text message and it says from Eric. And I'm like, oof.
It's all going to be really ugly. Capital letters. Yeah. You fucking fuck.
That's exactly what it was. So I hit read and I'm like, and my eyes are closed and I open them up. And it's like, all it says is, thanks a lot, bro.
Oh, no.
You wrote bro. All in big. Big fuck you letters,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah, he was in concert speak.
Right.
Yeah. Fuck you, bro.
Thanks a lot, bro. And you can tell that the bro was typed out really hard. B-R-O.
All in capitals.
All in capitals. And I'm like, this is going to be an ugly
I think
morning.
That bro was sarcastic.
So at 11:15, you're watching the parking lot empty?
Yeah, and at that point, I started calling Steve, because I figured, all right, Steve probably didn't leave early. Because he's not that far from there. Maybe Steve's still stuck in the parking lot. I can find Steve.
By the way, for the rest
of the
country.
Stuck in the parking lot, he actually looked up and saw...
there he goes. See, Steve...
Thanks, another message.
Thanks a lot. Steve stayed all the way through the fireworks, the encores, and the goodbyes, and the thank yous, because he doesn't have to wait in traffic with that hybrid.
No.
He flew over everybody.
Right over. Mick pointed at his car. It was great.
But look at that little thing.
It's the future.
But for the rest of the country, just so you know, Giant Stadium is in the middle of nowhere.
It's a swamp.
It's in the middle of a swamp. It's not... A lot of these stadiums in other cities, you can walk a little bit and you find maybe a taxi or something, but not this case. You don't want to be left in the swamp.
No.
So 11:15, you realize we're gone. You're calling
They're
Steve.
Gone.
So what happens?
No response from Steve. So I said, fuck, I better try to find that XM bus. So I go running over. Buses are gone.
Buses are gone?
Buses are gone.
Don't you have Will's number?
No, I don't.
You don't have any of
those buses
numbers?
Were gone. They cleared that whole area for this big wraparound line that went almost around the entire stadium for the buses for the
New Jersey
Transit Authority.
Oh, my God.
So that's where I wound up standing in line waiting to get a bus to get
back
to New York.
Wait a second. You said this morning the bus was full.
Right.
The XM bus was full.
Oh, wait. The guys won in. Come on in,
guys.
Oh,
Come on in, non-winners of $100,000.
What do you got to say, Danny?
No, I was just going to agree with Ben. He did say this morning that
He didn't get on the bus because the bus was full.
All
right. Not that the bus had left, but the bus was
full. This is now getting shaky on your part. The defense is falling apart.
No, but we need you know, you need to examine him as a character witness.
That's
true.
He's
also extremely jealous right now.
Yeah.
However, and also...
willing to sell him down the river.
I would seriously doubt with the money that XM spent and these high-profile clients that came in from all over the country, they would leave that fast and everybody would have gotten back to the bus because people are buying T-shirts and stuff at the retail.
Objection, speculation... on the prosecution.
Throw it out. Don't acknowledge his testimony now. Throw it out.
So you never saw the XM bus?
No, I didn't see them.
You're saying you never saw it,
but
you
told people that
it was full.
Because my name wasn't on the list.
What?
Wait, what?
this is falling apart quickly.
Yeah, there's something else to this story. There's something else that was going on.
Did you see the bus at all last night?
Didn't see that bus at all.
And you didn't see anyone from XM?
When I
From that party, there was 100 people at that party.
No, the sales. I was sitting where all the sales staff and their clients
were.
I had left before they did.
I want to get more into this. The bus was full statement you made this morning.
Mm-hmm.
What were you saying that about?
Yesterday, when I got the instructions for getting my ticket and how to get to the game, they said, "Do you need to go on the bus? Because the bus is going to be full. I'll put your name." No, I'm going with OP.
Oh, so you were speculating that the XM bus would be full on the way back also. So you didn't even use that as an option.
No, because I was supposedly going home with OP. And then when I realized maybe I could still try to catch the bus, there were no buses.
Mm-hmm. How did you get home?
Waited online to get a bus to the Port Authority.
That's terrific. That's terrific.
Oh, my. Let me ask you this. What's the worst thing you said as you were standing there muttering to yourself?
Yeah, right.
Exactly. What's the worst thing that you said?
Oh, I don't know. I was so...
I bet it was really bad and really personal and about Opie and Ben.
Wishing some sort of disease.
Right.
Here's the other thing, though. You just won $100,000 yesterday.
Cancer of the ass, that fuck.
How long did it take to get a bus?
I waited almost an hour and 20 minutes till I got to the bus.
Oh my God! And that's a long hour and 20.
Oh yeah.
That is a long. That isn't hanging out with a hot chick hour and 20. That isn't watching a good movie hour and 20. That is just looking at your watch every 3 minutes.
That's humid meadowland swamp air, and it. Ugh.
Oh,
day would end like that.
Right.
You win $100,000. You got wristbands for the Stones. And the end of the day, you're
nice
standing in a swamp
party
with the common people,
right,
waiting for the
muttering
New Jersey Transit, typing text messages to people who you thought were your friends.
I got
to
be honest with you. I got to be honest. I can look anyone in the eye, no problem, even when it gets a little tough. And Eric's been with us a year now. I'm having a tough time looking at him this
morning. Yeah, you guys fucked
him. For the first time.
Well,
you fucked him.
It gets worse.
All right, so you waited an hour and a half or an hour and 20 minutes for a Port Authority bus.
Now, you live in Brooklyn.
Yeah. What time was it when you got on the bus? Knowing that...
it had to be well after 1 a.m.
Oh, my God. Wow. I was already asleep for a solid 2 hours. A solid 2 hours.
Did you at least
get
to sit down on the bus, or are you standing in the aisle?
I sat down.
Like Mama!
Oh, God, this is awful.
Before we move on, Crazy Adam says there's a hole in Eric's defense. Crazy Adam.
Hey, if Ben has a different phone, doesn't the caller ID show the number? Why couldn't you call the caller ID back?
You said your BlackBerry is a different number, right?
Yeah, the BlackBerry is a Washington number.
Washington number.
Yeah, but a number's a number, man. I mean, still possible.
So Eric could have just called that number back, whatever it was.
I don't have that number. I have his New York number.
But did the number show up on your phone?
When Ben did call
when
you.
When Ben called you.
And did you really call my phone?
Yes, I called your phone.
Starting at
10:30. Plus, it's a D.C. area code. You probably think it's some boy you banged down there in a promotion.
I think the forensic guys there should take a look at his phone. Check
we
the
need
call
the phone records. Yeah.
We should have that guy from A&E do the narration.
You know what?
Yeah, this horrible tragedy.
You know what? Here's the deal.
1 a.m.
I did not bring...
Stranded at the Meadowlands.
I did not bring my phone in. Did you leave messages? There were some hang-ups.
Yeah,
I had
four
voicemails. Three were hang-ups. No, one was from Ben because he left something in my car. Two were hang-ups. And one was finally you just saying, thanks a lot. Or something like that.
So I don't have my phone on me. I could call my house, and we could get to the bottom of when those calls came in.
Okay.
All right, and I'll be completely honest. Okay. But I'm telling you, the phone did not ring from 10:30 when we started leaving, all the way until I dropped Ben off and went home.
There are people waiting for buses that aren't there. Why are they waiting for these buses?
But I will...
You go to the concert with three friends, you leave with two.
Nothing. I don't want to talk about it, Larry. It's awful. This poor man was standing there, and no one would pick him up. The bus was full. He had to ride next a lot of bro.
We got E-Rock's mind checking in. E-Rock's mind, what's up?
Worst thing I was thinking that night, it wasn't my pals. It was that fucking meal ticket comment. She was just pulling those strings.
Ah, the paycheck. The paycheck left you there, my friend.
You know what? That might have played into a little bit.
Oh, boy.
A seedy story of resentment.
Resentment?
Laying itself out in a swamp in New Jersey.
So, 11:15, you realize. So, what time did you get on the bus? 1:15, right?
I couldn't tell you. I know it was well after 1 a.m.
1:15, while Opie slept at home, Eric was just getting on a bus. What time would he get home? How would he get home? Stay tuned. We'll be back after these words.
So that is the music. Wow. Very good, Derek.
Very creepy. All right, so you're on a Port Authority bus back to Manhattan?
Yeah.
Which sucks because you live in Brooklyn. Mm-hmm. So you got to go all the way back to Manhattan and then take a what?
Yeah, now, what happens? The Jersey buses don't take you home to your house in Brooklyn.
No, so I get off at the Port Authority. Then I got to go downstairs and around this other area because they're cleaning, so they block that off to go to where the taxi line is.
Uh-huh.
All the cabs that are waiting there, going to Jersey, going to Jersey, going to Jersey. No. So I'm in this now another line waiting to get a taxi to try to get back to Brooklyn.
But
I get tapped. I turn around. It's Stalker Patty.
Hi.
What is Stalker Patty doing out in the middle of the night?
Her and those and a few other people were coming back from some gambling junket in Atlantic City.
Oh, she's hooked.
So she's like, "What are you doing here?" Waiting for a cab. Oh, it was nice to see you. And then she left. So
she will pop up everywhere.
It's really creepy.
It's not like it's a small town. This is friggin' this is New York City. And she pops up everywhere.
I finally had to tell her to stop following me on the subway, because she was doing that for a while.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. When I was still commuting back to Long Island. She would just happen to be on my subway, and after the third time of her saying, "Wow, what a coincidence." I'm like, "Patty, I know what you're doing. Stop. Please stop."
Eric, you could hop on the jitney. I'm sure the jitney will take you there.
How is she going to Atlantic City every goddamn weekend on weekdays? She was getting back from an Atlantic City junket on a Thursday.
Some slot machine tournament.
Get her on the phone. We got to hear about the slot machine
the
tournament.
The World Series of Losers
tournament. Like she got a headband on, like there's something fucking athletic about it.
Yeah, what kind of tournament is the. The machines are doing the work.
I don't like this bucket. I don't like it.
Warm ups are just cracking your knuckles a lot, you know, getting ready. All right, so what happens? You're on this line for a cab back to Brooklyn. What time is it?
It's now 2 a.m.
It's 2 in the morning.
We got to be here at, what, 5:30?
Just give us one sound bite of something that you said about either one of these two creeps who just left you there.
Honestly, I said, they're sitting in that car laughing that I'm still out here. I figured they did it intentionally because they've done it a few other places. But I never thought they would do it in here.
We did it where?
You tried doing it to me in Washington Station.
Well, no,
to the bathroom.
What he wanted to do to you in Washington would have been really bad because Ope wanted to report your bags. You went in the bathroom. Remember this? This is when we first went to Washington.
Oh, yeah.
You were
going
to say that you saw those bags unattended.
Oh, yeah, that,
the history of this.
Yeah, but then but we all decided that was a bad call.
Very bad. No, that's not a good idea.
Yeah.
But we did, I think, didn't we ditch you at the...
He was ditched once before.
Where were we?
We ditched him somewhere. Where? I'm remembering. It's like, where's Eric? We ditched him.
Where? I think it was at the train station in Washington.
Was it a car or a limo or something? Was it the X Games? I can't remember where it was, but there was some point where we were like, where's Eric? Fuck him. I remember that was said.
Patty's on the phone, by the way.
I know. We'll get to Patty in a second. So,
cha-ching.
So now it's after 2 a.m.?
Mm-hmm.
And you have to be... Why didn't you just come back to the station at that point?
You have to be here at 5:30 in the morning.
Oh, I was fed up, so I took a cab back, took a shower, slept, and then came back here to work.
How much did that whole trip cost you to come back?
$45.
$45. Yeah. Bag of shells, right? You right, my
have,
friend?
You still have $99,955.
That's right. Don't worry about it. You don't have $100,000 anymore. $45
And 5 hours of your life that you'll never get
back.
So
what did you do? Sleep an hour?
I think so. Like hour and a half, got up, and then came
to
work.
Because I gotta tell you, man, after sleeping 6 hours, I feel a little tired today.
Yeah.
Oh. Just a little tired. I usually get 8, but I got 6, so I'm a little groggy today.
My heart pulls for you.
No, for a guy who won $100,000, went to the Stones last night. He
doesn't
look that happy, does he?
He's miserable. That's $100,000. I'd have been walking home whistling Zippity Doodah. Right. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, you won $100,000. You got to see the Rolling Stones. Yeah. You know, not a bad day.
How much did the ticket cost you to see the Stones?
Nothing.
Exactly.
As much as
freebie.
As much as we fucked them, I think there's more to the story that you're not telling. That's
yeah, there's something going on.
There's something else that was going on that might have distracted you.
Any girls involved in this story that we don't know about?
No.
No?
Nope.
Come on, you're feeling good, you made some money, you want to be a big shot.
No.
You pull out your wad.
Big shot. No?
No. I had a great seat. The
concert
was
great. He
had
no money there, so he has to pull out his scratch and match ticket. I won! Trying to get the girls to go
didn't
with
the Daily News give you a t-shirt to wear?
I won.
We got scratch another
match.
Winner.
No. I am the winner.
Who's the winner? Right away.
Ladies!
One at a time.
All right, let's say hi to Matt in New Jersey. Matt, what's going on today?
Hey guys,
hey.
I was just calling and tell you, Eric, let this die. If you would have made Opie late this morning or had him sleeping late, you know how pissed off you would be for the rest of the day? Just let it die and count your thousands of dollars.
Yeah, it's one of those sucks to be you type of things.
All right, why don't you let the listeners be the jury?
Yeah, Jeremy, what's up?
How you doing, guys? Why should we care? Why couldn't, like, Scrooge McDuck here spend $75, rent himself a car service, and be home in 45 minutes?
Exactly.
It's a heartless jury. That's two for the prosecution.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you know you could have just called the numbers you hear all the time, 777-7777, one of those, and you could have gotten a town car to pick you up, drive you from there to your door, for probably a little bit more than you wound up spending anyway.
Not only that, I mean, there's plenty of cars going back. I've gone and just asked people, hey, going back to Manhattan, can I give you $20 or whatever? People
yeah,
do
you
that
just
all
go
the
up
time.
To the windows of the cars and go, hey, take me back there. I'll throw you some money. Here's my friend. They take you right back.
But that's a whole other side. You're just saying what he should do after they fucked him.
After they fucked him. Well,
it's like, yeah,
you've already been fucked.
Don't take a shower. Wait till the police examine your privates.
Exactly.
That's what you're saying.
They gotta get the rape kit.
The guy got raped. You
gotta
fucking
pull out the rape
kit
and take some swabs.
Yeah, I mean, you're spinning this off into another.
I
we're
know.
Talking about the initial.
Right. I'm at the point where you're like, you should go to therapy. You should try to work. But
what a roller coaster of a day for the guy, though, man.
Holy crap, Chuck.
Let's. You want to go to some of these phone calls? Let's go to North Carolina, Chuck. What's going on?
I was just wondering if Rosie was on the bus with him.
Hey, this is Eric. He just won money. And his friends fucked him and left him at the concert.
Oh, that horrible movie Rosie did where she played the retard. You see that one? It's classic.
Oh, it's great.
His friends left him. And now he's fucked.
That's exactly how she sounded.
Look at his text. He's texting something. Wait a minute. Fuck off, bro.
Matt Jersey.
Hey, I just noticed that this continues the streak of good luck for the show after Jimmy left, you know? You guys get lesbians, now Eric wins $100,000. What's next?
That is true.
That is true. We've been on a nice roll, except for the Rolling
Stones
thing.
Streak of luck.
Thing.
Well, that was just for Eric.
Net.
The guy, let's weigh out the fucking luck here, people. let's put it on the scales over here. You win $100,000. You had to spend $45 and a couple of hours getting home from the Stones show. I think it evens out somewhere.
Not even evens out. By tomorrow morning when you wake up, when you get a good night's sleep, that'll just be a little nuisance thing. You still got the $100,000.
Most people would be happy just to have a free Rolling Stones ticket. The tour's completely sold out. You know, so he got screwed going back.
Nobody,
he won $100,000 on top of it.
How many people
I wanna,
hitched
I wanna
home
point
from
to
Woodstock,
the jury
man?
That the prosecution just admitted
to
fucking him over.
I heard that. I heard
he
that.
Just admitted.
I really
he got
think
screwed.
Eric's not thankful enough.
for the fine day he had
yesterday. Motivation.
Look at his face. He's like, I should be thanking you.
You want $100,000? Let's put this on the table. You want $100,000?
He's establishing motive right now.
Right.
This guy's grateful enough.
A wonderful VIP party with free booze and food.
Oh, but are you saying you want Eric to say thank you to you?
Yeah.
Oh, he is kind of right. At any point, did he go into like some sort of convenience store and you guys hatched this plan? Look at him in there.
Actually,
he's Coke. He doesn't look thankful, does he? Son of a bitch wins $100,000.
He should be thanking
him.
What did I do?
He got your tickets. He got your ticket.
Yes, you did. Anthony was offered the tickets.
Yeah, I was. And he didn't go.
Eric, all I'm asking today is
that could have been me getting fucked.
All I'm asking today is that you thank me. That's all.
Wow.
It was a VIP party, free booze, free food, really nice Rolling Stones
table. Don't do it, Eric. If you do that, I'll beat you with that microphone.
You had a nice ride to the venue.
You got a free T-shirt, a free program.
Right.
Let him in your head, Eric.
And I just want to add this to the pile. I picked you out of obscurity. When you were just working for a tiny little station in the middle of nowhere in Florida. You've never officially thanked me on the air.
Wow. That's a ballsy move, man.
What do you think?
Can I pick and choose what I can thank you for?
No.
You know what?
Just one general thank you. That's all.
Oh,
remember when I was coming back from Florida and I met you in the middle of nowhere on a...
Okay, thank you for the career.
I can't believe it. You know what, dude?
No.
You fucking deserve to be left in a swamp.
That's going to be my greatest accomplishment ever.
Oh, man.
I can't believe I just spent fucking a half hour defending you, and you turn around and do that
thank
shit?
Him.
Who the fuck raised you? This is the most pathetic thing I've ever heard in my life. They left you in a fucking swamp. He doesn't have a fucking leg to stand on.
Oh, my
God. And over the air, you just fucking genuflect. You just kissed his fucking ring.
But I had a lot of ammo, man. He never thanked me. I actually pulled over at a what? What was it, a Cracker Barrel?
Yeah,
we went to eat at a Cracker Barrel in the middle of nowhere, in the middle of Florida. That's how I met the kid.
He's me with the cat box, the garbage, and the vacuum.
Unbelievable.
Just smiling.
Shoulder slump.
You are step and fetch it.
How much money do you need to win before you get some fucking spine in you?
You have an FU nest egg right there. It's FU money.
Yeah.
Dude, you're a battered woman sometimes, really.
Yeah.
He didn't mean it. He didn't mean it. I know he really cares deep down.
He didn't even
do that.
And he said
he's going to change. No.
Yeah, you said, you need to thank me.
He smacked him again.
Fucking swamp, and he did it.
Eric, not for the swamp.
Eric started,
semantics,
Eric
what you thanked
this,
him for.
Eric started this morning going to himself, oh, I'm going to give him a piece of my mind.
Yeah.
And by the end of the morning, he's thanking me.
He had a moment of courage. Thanks a lot, bro.
Bro.
Finally welled up in him, and you beat him back down.
Now we realize he was really thanking him. Thanks a lot, bro.
Oh, wow.
Holy crap.
I don't know what to tell you, man. I tried to
hold
defend
on.
You.
Hold on. Danny, what's up?
Well, not that. I was just thinking about this whole scratch and match situation.
Yeah.
And I could swear that Eric was taking the scratch and match things out of the show papers that we get every morning.
Oh, no, boy.
So, I mean, and technically the papers are delivered to Ben.
And technically you ain't getting shit.
Oh. Well,
I'm not,
oh.
Face.
Hey, you got a set of balls. I don't get too mad at that.
Hey, Danny. What's this world coming to?
Hey.
Danny's going to shoot him
in
the
foot. I'm not asking
fuck
for
you,
any.
Spider.
Yeah, you are.
I thought you said Spider.
Maybe
the papers were everyone, Spider.
Eric fought back and everyone stood up. Come on.
Hey.
Bring it on.
Danny just got a raise.
Was it the...
No.
Papers from here?
No.
So that would make a big difference. I think
no,
they better
one,
write another
get
name
the
on that
Sunday
check.
Daily News here, too. I bring them from home.
Ben saying, yes, we do
we
get,
do
the,
get
Sunday
the Sunday
Daily,
Daily
News.
News.
And that Sunday, we pulled it out. And didn't we pull out and realize that those two were winners in the Sunday paper that we got here? And that made us think, wow, this really is widespread, because not only did Eric Nagel say he won, but this paper's from the station actually won $100,000.
Oh, wait, I do remember that.
You know what? He's right. We did do that. Because there were so many winners, I was like, wow, they really did fuck up, because what are the odds that you're going to win and the station papers are going to win? Now, are you sure that was yours?
I'm positive it was mine.
Hmm.
I know exactly what happened.
Oh, Travis knows exactly what happened.
I came in that day, and I brought
and I went home after that. Thank you. I want to take no chances in this.
And I brought the story up, and Eric goes, oh, I have a copy of the scratch and match in the studio. I'll run in and see if I win.
Oh!
And he scratched it off, and lo and behold, he won. And then after the show, he said, of course I'm going to mail it in. What? Why wouldn't I?
You're saying
absolutely.
That absolutely the one that he sent in was from the station's
absolutely.
Paper.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
No.
Yes.
No.
It
when
was
I
sitting
came
in that bin that you had over there for months.
Oh, man.
It was pink.
No. What do we got, about 10
absolutely.
People working?
Actually, no, it's
perfect.
I
want my 10 grand.
10 grand, 10 grand, 10 grand, 10 grand.
10 grand for everybody.
Wow.
Eric, I want you to apologize
no.
for using one of the station's papers.
Why wouldn't you apologize for taking food out of their mouths? This is what you're doing.
Because, one, it wasn't a station paper.
Well,
Travis disagrees with that.
Station paper.
He can disagree all he wants. He's not getting
Let's
any
Let's get a
money.
Lawyer. This would make for great radio,
wow.
man. Let's sue one of our own.
I think they deserve to share
spend.
In this.
Make him spend 80 grand of the winnings on defense.
Oh, Jesus.
He would, too.
Eric, if you just get... See, I'm thinking I don't know. I should get... There's 10 of us, right? I should get 10,000. You give me 1,000, I won't sue you.
No.
You want to settle it? Just settle out?
I'll just settle out.
What do you think about settling out with everybody? A grand for
How about,
everyone. That's no. nothing, really. 10 grand yeah. out of 100 grand?
I'll tell you, I would have done it anyways.
You got
to
do
right.
something.
Yeah. Just to be How a decent a, guy.
How about a nice, like, lunch for everybody? Something.
Yeah, I offered that to all of them yesterday. I said I was going to take them out to lunch
spender.
And dinner.
But now you don't want to take them out because they just threw you under a bus. I didn't throw you under a bus. Those guys.
That was one
did.
Of the first things I said.
By leaving his ass in the swamp. Somehow it ends up with you apologizing to him. I've never
this
fucking
is,
seen that.
I unbelievable.
I really can't believe that they would throw you under a bus
oh,
like
I could.
That.
Yeah.
You know?
Look at
I would
all
never
them.
Do that to you.
Where are you taking him to lunch?
What happened
I don't
5
know.
Minutes ago?
Would you guys accept lunch from him? No, they're all shaking their heads. No. They don't want it.
Wow.
They don't want it.
Let's see. Which way? Let's say hi to... Does Eric have a car? I guess we're done.
What are you going to do with the 100 grand? What do you got? Any plans?
Just going to invest it.
Invest it. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. What are you investing in?
Not sure yet. I'm working on that.
Citadel stock.
Yeah, you want to buy some Citadel?
Yeah, I'll give you my Citadel stock.
Something safe? Something long-term or a little risky to make money quickly on?
Something long-term, I think.
Yeah?
You want
mutual funds?
Blue chips.
Let's have you talk to that tough guy, Barry Shapiro. Guy that packs a mean punch. Yeah.
Wow. All right, we'll talk to Stalker Patty after the break, I guess.
About her Atlantic City junket. I think she's really getting addicted to the gambling thing. She seems to be going all the time.
I'm glad we cleared this up, Eric.
And your apology is accepted.
Yeah, I'll accept your apology. All's well now.
I like how he's sitting there thinking it over. How the fuck did that happen? I was so right.
So right, yet he...
Apologized.
He apologized.
And thanked someone for his career. He still has wow. fucking dirt on his knees from that swamp.
The swamp. He left him at a swamp.
Oh, I've never seen
worst.
Anything like this.
That's the end of it. Thanks, mate. Bill Burr is going to be on HBO tonight at midnight. Half-hour comedy special.
I'll watch that one for sure.
On HBO.
He's a very funny guy, but I'm not going to really push it anymore because he wasn't on my side during that last break.
It was just such
a
gang mentality.
No one
Someone
was.
Had to defend it.
That's what happens on
and
the
I
show,
And I did
though.
Up until the apology.
No one comes to your side on the show. You fuck up. Everyone attacks. Everybody. Everyone. Let's see. Oh, we want to talk to Stalker Patty.
Yeah, I want to know how she's what she's doing.
During Eric's adventure last night, he ended up on a taxi line at 2 in the morning, and Stalker Patty was behind you, right?
Yeah.
Something like that. And we got Stalker Patty on the phone. Stalker Patty.
Hey, how you doing?
Hi, Patty.
Hi.
Now, you saw Eric?
Yes, I did. He was on a taxi stand at about 10 to 1 in the morning. I was just getting off the bus.
You were just getting off the bus?
Yeah, I went to Atlantic City because I got invited to a slot tournament. I go about once a month because it's something to do.
slot tournament.
What's a slot tournament?
You bring a card, you hand it in, you get taken to a machine, you have 7 minutes to play, and whoever has the 50 highest scores cashes. I never win. I only had 4,400. The lowest score was like 7,000. Yes, it's just luck of the draw.
It's a slot machine.
Yeah, there's no skill involved.
Yeah, so I went down there for it, and then I just hung around. I won about $75, so that was nice.
Oh, you're up?
That's my big win.
How does she win? How does anyone win at the slots?
I don't know.
What do you play, the nickel?
I did the quarter ones.
Ooh.
Well, you're living, huh? You're living.
And sometimes the penny ones I like, you know. I can't afford to do the others. But
Patty,
I
you fun. Can't afford to go there. You should be saving those quarters for food.
Yeah, but if I didn't do that, I'd be sitting home doing nothing. I don't go anywhere. I don't really have a social life, so it's just something.
Really?
This is the other side of gambling they don't want you to know about, you know? This woman needs every penny she can.
These are the kind of people who show up to the comedy show after they're out of pennies or nickels and just sitting there with slumped shoulders.
Yeah, because they have 2 hours to kill before the bus takes them back to the city.
Yeah.
You know, I go on the boardwalk, too. It's the only time I see the ocean.
Jump in it.
No, I just like going there just for something to do, and I like the ocean. I like the ride down and back. I don't do very much with the machines. I like watching the people do the tapes because they look kind of funny to me when they act, when they win and stuff.
Opie's so right. This is the side they don't want you to see. They want you to see the glamour, the World Series of Poker with the guys. Let's bring out the $1 million and put it on the table, and these last two people are going to be playing for $1 million cash. Right. And there's Patty throwing her quarters best spent on food in this slot machine after taking a stinky bus ride with a bunch of Asians.
I don't have anything better to do.
No, it's a bunch of old people. It's
old people.
Yeah, I don't mind it.
I ended up in Vegas with Stephen Lynch's crew when I was just wandering around the country. I took a ride from L.A. to Vegas through the desert and stuff with a bunch of L.A. dudes that looked like they were in Stone Temple Pilots. They all looked like rock stars, even though they just worked at, like, a Starbucks. And we're there for Stephen Lynch. He was playing, I guess it was the Hard Rock at the time. And all of a sudden, these guys, I was hanging out with them all week, and they're like, you want to see the real Vegas? I'm like, yeah. Two, maybe three blocks from all the glam and glitter.
Mm-hmm.
Holy shit. And it's right there. It's not that far from the strip.
Yeah.
Places where they say they'll accept your car title and your house title for loans.
Oh, shit.
Right off the strip, saying, you know, we will accept whatever it is, your house, what is it called, a house?
And you know, yeah, your deed.
And your deed, and then there's motels that are for like, I don't know, like $10, no joke, like $10 a night. And you got people just wandering around, just like they lost it all.
I like the slot machines and the gas stations. Like, who can't get away? You know, you're leaving, you want to fill up your tank and leave. Who needs that one last pull or something, you know?
Right.
No, it's even worse if you win, because then you're turning your fucking car
back. How are you going
back? Here we go, I'm on a streak. Or you stay at the gas station. This machine's hot.
Right.
Sir, at least move your car away from the pump. No, I walk away. I jinx myself.
Yeah, I can't
keep
leave.
Keep the car. I'm up 75.
I don't know how anyone, you know, lives in Vegas. Because when you go there, you get just pulled into it, obviously.
You really do.
But when you're living there and these slot machines are in grocery stores, the Starbucks, the gas stations, I don't know.
I'm not. How many times you got a cab driver out there and he's got a story?
Oh, they all do, yep.
Oh, yeah, all fucking, I stay out of those places.
Everyone that works there is like, no, I don't gamble at all. I stay away from it. No drinking. They're all born-again Christians.
Yeah.
I think they sold themselves into some sort of slavery out there. It was going to take the last roll of the dice.
To the cab company. Yeah, there's some kind of slave labor.
You know, I wasn't going to go there. I did notice something during Starker Patty's phone call. She's still on the line, by the way.
Yeah.
I wasn't going to go there, but the phones are going nuts. They really are. There's like five people that have the same comment. Larry, go ahead.
Hey, did anybody catch what happened there just then? He says, Eric said he didn't get on the, he didn't leave the bus till way after one, yet Starker Patty said she saw him at the taxi stand at 10 till 1.
Patty.
Patty?
Starker Patty?
Yes. No. It was about 10 to 1 because that's when I got off the bus and came up outside and I saw him there.
See, she's crazy.
Right on,
she knows time.
Yeah, crazy people are like, they know the time
all the time.
She knows every time she does everything. She's like anal like that. She knows. So if she says that she saw you at 10 to 1, it was 10 to 1.
Big hole in the story there.
It's like the third person in line.
Did he look happy?
He looked kind of like tired.
That would be the look.
Imbibing. I think he imbibed a little too much.
Imbibed.
All right. Well, there you have it.
Imbibe some arsenic.
All right, thanks, guys. Punch it out.
Thanks, Larry.
Half of the page on the New York Post is the $4 million scratch and win. New card game inside.
Right.
So I guess there's a new one there, Eric. You might want to get in on that. Are you allowed to win again?
Different paper.
Oh, that's right. Oh, what do I know, Post? You think the Post would crop your picture so not one bit of Opie and Anthony are in the picture that they took? It's motherfuckers over there at the Daily News. He wins $100,000. They come in to take a picture of him. He makes sure he's standing in front of the big Opie and Anthony sign. He's wearing like an ONA shirt and everything. They cropped it like you saw his eyes, nose, and mouth. That was it. They did not want to advertise this program.
Oh, I thought you guys were in the photo too, like you actually waited around for
that
half hour.
That would have been good.
Like the fucking dude dating like a Hollywood starlet that nobody knows.
Right.
He's standing there on the red carpet like he's going to be in there. Now my acting career is going to soar. No, buddy.
Yeah, they cut him right out.
If I hung out for an hour to take a picture, that would have been a story in itself, newsworthy. I am out of here at 11 o'clock.
Very, very good.
Watching Eric take a picture. There it is. And I must say,
this is from yesterday's Daily News.
I didn't see the rest of the proud winners. Again, Eric, you look miserable.
You won $100,000.
Will
you
be
smile?
Happy? You are a miserable fuck. Can you be happy?
Oh, yeah. I'm good.
Oh, Nathaniel's saying that's his smug look. Is that your smug look? Yeah, I won, motherfucker. Look at him. Let's see. There's a couple of old ladies, a black woman, and Eric. Wow. That's some demographic you got there. Queens, two from the Bronx and one from Brooklyn. Representing. See that?
Yeah, I saw it in the paper yesterday. Eric, you look really sad. Everyone else is smiling. You're that miserable around here?
No. Is that it?
Not at all.
What was the look for?
Yeah. It was 2 o'clock. I was tired. The best part, Eric goes, yeah, they used a bad picture. But you're not even smiling. You're not even attempting to look happy.
Well, later on, he's like, do you think you could smile? So he took a few more with me smiling in front of the sign.
And they didn't use it.
They didn't use it.
Yeah, you want $100,000 of our money. Could you smile?
That asshole, could you smile? This was a big deal for us.
They cropped his picture so much that his picture is actually popping out of the little square frame they made of it.
Right. It shows you like dimension.
Yeah, is that it?
A little 3D action.
Yeah.
He's probably going to get investigated. He looks like he stole it, doesn't he? Like he doctored the ticket.
Dude, he won't pay taxes on it. There'll be a big problem. This will just cause him problems. Yeah. You going to pay taxes on that, cabbie? Or are you just going to say fuck it? Oh, wow. Copy of the check.
The actual check.
Daily News, the sum of $100,000. Wow. That's nice. Did you take it to the bank?
Not yet.
No?
Why did you cross out your address? You thought we were going to read it on the air or something?
Of course.
You can't send people over to the Nagel estate.
Blackmail.
The security cameras will pick it up and he'll have to send his men out.
That's pretty cool, though, man.
That is.
$1,000 from the Daily News.
What are you going to do now when you bring it to the bank? You got to wait. Let me give you a pointer here, my friend. You wait till one of the attractive female tellers are open. And you bring that up and just kind of throw it like you do it all the time.
It's like,
there you go.
Here's my weekly paycheck.
And then that might spark a little conversation. Before you know it, you're in.
Dating a hot banker.
Yeah, that Daily News. I'm a photographer. You know that picture that I had of J-Lo, Beyonce in there? That was me. I took that one. I think I could take a few pictures of you. You could wheel that into a chick and the money.
Not a bad idea.
Do it.
And you buy like a fake Pulitzer Prize for when you get it back to your apartment.
That's the Pulitzer. Yeah. I don't know.
I was over in Iraq the first time.
Yeah. The real one.
Right.
She'd buy it. 100 grand, my friend. Daily News is right on the check.
There you go. It was legit. He's got the check and the picture in the paper to prove it.
Mr.
him. Yeah, right. Exactly.
Money's
I know
no object. Well, just ask Hawk. Where's Hawk? He knows. He just won $100,000.
Big spender.
He just won 100
G's.
100 large.
100 G's.
He's going to be out on the town. Yeah. You can see him picking
up
some broads.
Yeah.
Well, we'll see. Let's ask him some broads here.
What do you think of this guy right here?
Here he comes.
Ha.
Look at him.
How did you win $100,000? I'm not aware.
Oh, very skillful.
Oh, yeah?
Very skillful. Yeah, poker.
Selling your body on the streets?
No, that's it.
He mailed something into the Daily News.
Like an old woman.
Wow. Yeah, like an old washwoman.
Actually, it was all old women and Eric that won.
Yeah, old women and Eric won.
What lucky lady are you going to take out? What are you going to do for your woman? Do you have a woman?
Yeah,
I do.
Multiple women?
No, just one.
Just one woman?
Just one.
How long have you been with her?
Several months now.
Oh, and
several.
So what are you gonna get her? Chanel
I don't know
purse.
Yet.
Yeah, she's
going to be shopping when she comes out here.
Is she like a high I say high maintenance in the best possible way. Hmm. She like shopping or, you know, what's her deal? Sports?
No, she's very low maintenance, but when she comes in, I'm going to take her shopping.
Oh.
Where?
Really?
She wants to go to Tiffany's, so.
Oh, yeah. Let me tell you nice. Something about Tiffany's.
Yeah. Good luck.
100 grand to go real quick.
There, no.
No, let me tell you, you will get a very
his
good night of loving after that.
This money's going to be done in a weekend.
You're totally getting fucked. Don't go to Tiffany's.
You can spend $100 on a whore and get the exact thing you want.
That was the best.
No,
that is propaganda.
God, that's when I wish this was television.
That's when
she goes, you're going to get a good night of loving for that. And then Bill's face is... He threw his arms up and looked around like, what the fuck? What the fuck?
That's that Oprah propaganda.
Listen, yeah. Hawk is looking for love, not
this
just
This is
going
to be... Yeah. She's okay. speaking love. For somebody else. This,
I
this
can
is
tell.
A
right.
pattern.
Sweet face.
The rapist.
All right, when you
Let's
go,
see, you want me to speak for you?
Julia, no. when you go out with him?
Sure.
Oh.
Without the money?
No. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. No, if I didn't have a boyfriend, yeah.
Oh, if I didn't have a boyfriend.
It's a great excuse, isn't it?
You wouldn't go out with him. Be honest.
Not at all.
He's a good guy to
cheat
with, though.
I
would you go out with him?
Exactly.
Because I think that you should give everyone a chance. He could be amazing in bed.
That's
who
bullshit.
Knows? Oh, come on.
Jesus.
You heard $100,000 and your eyes poked.
Nah, $100,000 is not going to impress me.
Yeah,
$100,000
is nothing.
No, I'm really happy for you. I would love $100,000. So, you know, you want to donate.
Why would you go out with him?
Because I think it could be interesting.
Why? He's a zero.
Everyone. No. That's not nice.
Liar whore, and you know it.
Who's that guy? You guys just put that on every now and again. No, you give everyone a chance. That's the problem with women right now is they are too picky. You have to go out and see what the guy is like. You know,
women,
you could be a Casanova underneath his polo shirt.
I'm calling Bravo Sierra.
You would
not go out with
easy
Eric.
With the language, Opie.
Bravo Sierra.
You're just trying to be, like, nice.
Well, professionally, you'd go out
with him. Yeah, on the radio.
And then, see, professionally, and then she'd write about it and, you know, words like... Dork and shit would be.
I love dorks. I love them.
Do you?
Yeah. I don't go for the Brad Pitt type. I go for the Zach Braff type. Yeah.
Really?
You and I are
manipulated.
Have a huge thing for him. Yeah.
Dorks are easily that easy prey.
Look at the bitter Bill. You are just so like. Yeah, stay easily manipulated.
I gotta do something. Are you gonna
listen? Let me say.
I gotta. You know, I'm playing devil's advocate.
Of course.
Bill's trying. All I want is a guy who's gonna talk string theory.
Bill's had some. Bill's had some recent problems. That's all we're gonna say. Right now.
Uh-huh, okay.
Recent problems. So he's a little bitter right now.
What are you bitter about?
I'm not bitter.
It's not working correctly? Or what?
What isn't working? Oh,
I think if you want somebody...
Cock, fucking hack.
It's not what you guys, how you use it.
I think if you want somebody that is going to speak string theory, maybe it's Stephen Hawking and not Hawk.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm not sure how...
That's hot.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, very clever, Laszlo.
I'm working.
You're redeeming
yourself. I worked on that all night.
Do you have...
I'm going to cock block him.
Crash everything you say.
Can we get E-Rock in here?
You could hear it in his tone. He was serious.
Let's get E-Rock.
Yeah, I got to call him out on something. We've been doing the Opie and Anthony movie trailers, and for the last, like, week, he's been handing me a movie trailer I guess he did for our old show or something. And he wants us to replay it.
I forgot. Oh, I love when I forget.
E-Rock with his walk-on music.
Yeah. What's up, E-Rock?
He's not amused.
Have you spent that $100,000 yet?
Some of it. Not
a lot. What are you buying?
Furniture.
Furniture.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty exciting.
That's good. Nice for the apartment.
Mm-hmm.
Why horrendous. The low energy?
I'm sick. Uh-oh. I've been fighting it since Friday.
Oh, my God.
So why'd you come into work?
What do you got?
You're not doing anyone a favor. Trust me. We are so germ-conscious these days. He actually told me this because we had to ride the elevator up, and I was trying to be nice. I'm just thinking to myself, great, I'll be sick by Wednesday.
Once you feel any heat from the body, from the breath, from anywhere, you feel heat on you, you're infected. It's over. You're in the hot zone.
That's all it takes?
Yeah. That heat. It's full of sick.
What do you think you have
hot
that
sick.
We're all going to have by Wednesday?
My throat is just really bad.
Oh, great. Strep throat. That's the one I get every year.
Oh, I'm feeling a little.
Good.
Strep furniture? That's exciting.
What did you pick up?
Furniture-wise?
Yes.
I haven't gotten it yet. A bed.
A bed?
And a new couch.
Where'd you go?
IKEA. Thanks to Big Kev.
Look.
You know what that's like? That's like the prizes at the end of the Wheel of Fortune.
Exactly.
They had the worst... You win
it's
all this
awful.
Money and you, the selection.
Yeah.
For $700, I'll take the brass bed frame.
Yeah. Yeah, remember that when you used to have to buy the prizes? You spend all that money? How about the cash? And it's crap. Oh, my God, he went to IKEA.
Why would you go to IKEA? You won $100,000.
Not only is it garbage.
And I'm sure IKEA does a good job, but it's affordable furniture.
You got to build it yourself, right?
It's a lot of this stuff.
The Allen wrench.
You bring your couch home in a box, a few different boxes. You got to assemble yourself.
They supply the wrenches in a little plastic bag.
Why would
staple
you go
to the bottom?
There's always a couple
stapler.
Of screws missing.
Something's missing.
They sell furniture that you see at like beach houses.
Yeah. Yeah, you're not going to be there all the time. You just need something to fill a room up.
Pretty much. I don't need anything fancy. But when it gets delivered, it's not even going to be set up.
What about the bed? You got that from IKEA, too?
Just the bed frame, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Not the mattress, though.
No. I already have that. That's
it's laying on the floor now, and you're...
On a box spring.
You're even dull when you go to buy furniture.
Money bags.
Yeah, what are you doing? You
Nothing.
Won $100,000.
Yeah.
You went
to
IKEA.
Up a notch. Were you smoking a cigar? Harf, harf, I'd like to see something in a sofa. Harf, harf.
What's this scary...
Money hanging out of his pocket.
What's this movie trailer thing that you keep pushing on me?
It's the movie Scream. It's a movie trailer of the movie Scream with Andrew Dice Clay mixed into it. I had sent it to you back at the old show.
Remember him?
Did we play
you
it on the old show?
You sent this in?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
When you were just a fan.
So you put this together.
We make dreams come true here on the Opie and Anthony program.
Mm-hmm.
He went from
retarded
fan
young children
to working for the show.
Yeah.
Did we play? We did.
I think only once, and that was it.
Uh-oh. Dude, back
then. We used
then,
to play shit.
A million times just to, you know, to eat up time.
If it was even halfway decent.
Oh, my God. You're admitting that we only played it once?
I'm not aware of.
You know what that means. We never listened to this stuff beforehand, so we'll play it on the air and go, okay, here you go. And throw it to the side, never to be heard again. Well, let's take a listen here.
All right, let's listen.
Boundary Music Pictures presents a hairy banana film. Someone is playing a deadly game.
It all began with the scream over 911.
Someone who's seen one too many scary movies. Now he's taking his love of fear.
Sydney.
Yeah, who the f*** is calling this house 11:30 at night?
One step too far.
Who the f*** is this?
Tell me your name, I'll tell you mine.
Ferragamo.
What's your favorite scary movie?
It's all porno movies. Rub eggs and tomato sauce all over your big f*** so I shoot one in my pants.
Are you alone in the house?
Oh, I'm gonna quit. There are certain rules
that one must abide by in order to successfully survive a horror movie. Number one, you can never have sex.
Who shall wet the hoe?
Number two, never, ever, ever, under any circumstances, say, I'll be right back. Because you won't be back.
I'm getting another beer. You want one?
Yeah, sure.
I'll be right back.
Yeah, go for you.
He didn't make the rules. He just kills by them.
Listen, you little bitch. You hang up on me again, I'll cut you like a fish, understand?
Here, Goofy, here's a little penknife. You can cut people's feet when you get mad. Go ahead.
Don't answer the phone. Don't open the door.
Yeah, just shut up before I choke you to death.
Don't try to hide.
Everybody's a suspect! Go
ahead. Scary.
Scary scumbag, too.
I'm over here.
Sydney.
Starts Friday in an O&A market near you.
All right.
It's good production.
Yeah. Got any Y2K material?
Let's say hi to Jason in Texas. Jason!
Opie, man, I love the show, but I got to call you out. You're giving Eric a hard time about buying that cheap furniture. You're a big millionaire with all the money, and what's in your house, brother?
Well, I have a couch.
And?
I have a dresser, finally, but the clothes are on top of the dresser still, by the way. That's the update on the dresser, because someone was asking about that. It's
and?
And I have a bed.
And at least, oh, I mean, at least Eric, he got, you know, $100,000. You know, what's $100,000 to you? That's $2 million back to shell.
All right, I'll try to get a, I don't know, maybe, what else can I get? Maybe,
get a nightstand for the first time.
Do you own a coffee table?
Yeah, I finally got, oh, I did get a glass coffee table.
Oh!
Wait, is a coffee table the one that goes in front of the couch?
Yeah.
Oh, no, I don't have one of those.
What did you get?
I guess it would be an end table.
You got an end table before you got a coffee table?
Yeah.
Hey, guys, love the show, punching out.
All right. Jason makes a good point. All right, Eric, thank you. That was wonderful. Good luck with the strep throat.
Yeah.
How's the auction going?
Auction's going good. Ends this week.
Quiet.
Ends this week? Mm-hmm. As far as what?
As far as everything. We've got about 3 days left.
3 days left on the last items?
Mm-hmm. On the last items.
We raised about $50,000 so far, right?
Yeah, about.
Very cool. How's that Al Pacino poster?
$960 the last time
That's
I
it?
Left.
For the Scarface poster signed by everybody, including Al Pacino.
Mm-hmm.
Go to opiananthony.com for the link to the Opie and Anthony auction. Mm. There he goes, E-Rock.
Playing him in time to the music. Fantastic. Nick L. says, wow, I remember this. Good work, E-Rock. Now go get your fucking shine box.
Oof.
Nothing. Crash me saying that.